Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. And the game has blessed us with a new challenge. How easy is it to beat the Corman demo with only one Beazle? Beazle is really OP. You have Rage for more attacking power, Precision Knife for some more evasion boosting, maybe even poisoning Vodkar with Venomous Bees, and Feelers which makes your next attack 2.5 times if you don't switch out from Beazle. We also have some good variety of trade. We also have some good variety in the tracer department. Strategist for double the crit chance if we move last. Inner fire for freezes, slippery for that status moves, and antidote for after battle poison curing. We are a fast sweeper from the stats, and I guess let's get on with the challenge. I wake up in myself an orange outfit and name myself Behave because puns and swarmy only theme. Go and catch a first encounter. Go and get your first encounter potent, Mino. Catch a swarmy. Immediately replace Swarmy with Buzzy and challenge the Beazle. But my Beazle was faster and superior to the rest. My Beazle was superior and faster. I don't know why I wrote to the rest in the script. But anyway, so after that, I give Penny my gauntlet, get books from Marin, forget helping Monica, beat Jebediah, fix the broken teleporter, and beat the sick Beazle in town. Because this town ain't big enough for the both of us. Well, it is, but you get my point. In doing that, I noticed two new cool things. First is that you can push open a blacksmith door with a push module, and it will stay open. And second, I gave Chuck a potent Mino. And when I wanted to fight him, it was a potent one. You can apparently also give it a nickname. Also perfect. And also grind up to level 25 and it will still be level 25. So, that is really cool. You know, my respect for the game was actually already very high up. But this just made it go all the way up. Anyway, I head through Wood of Forest without any major problems, like every single challenge I did. Emphasis on the major, because, not mad at all. I could do this all day, yeah. I also named my Beazle Roop, because I forgot to do that. And Roop was the one who suggested the Beazle only run. I then go to the North Island and get Roop's potential from 15 to 16 and go through Thunderous Cave without any problems. Absolutely destroy the fuse box with plus 6 attack, feelers and a double sting. Rescue Thomas and then watch him get kidnapped for the 40th time. I'm pretty sure. It may be. I don't know, so I'm pretty sure it's my 40th time, or maybe 41st. And then I head to the power tower. I can mostly sweep everything because I use feelers for 1 or 2 Coromon, and go and stop rage for 3 or more Coromon. Nothing was really hard even Jeffrey, because Embevel is not really all that strong. Which is sad, because Toruga is the best. And now we're at Vodkar. On basically page 2 of the script. Here are my stats. Body is decent, they're not great since I'm not at full HP. If I'm not at full HP, I get one shot by Super Punch. I also changed my trait to Slippery since the chance to only crit works only the turns I'm attacking. And that is going to be like 2 or 3 turns. Because I'm going to set up a bit. And every attempt, which made everything very stressful. So yeah, I also want to touch Taser because it's really annoying when I get fully paralyzed. So yeah, slippery it is. Let's see how it goes. I went into the battle with an Oki fruit because of that attack boost, meaning I would only need 6 turns to fully set up, plus 6 attack, plus 6 evasion. But Volcar sadly didn't get rope in the 25% range often. So for most of the time I just ended up with plus 3 in attack. Normally I would just go to plus 6, but since I have an Oki fruit, if it activates, then I'm going to be basically wasting like 1 or 2 stages, or even 3 if I'm at plus 6, because the Oki fruit raises your attack by 3 stages. So yeah, 3 is the most I am willing to go. But anyway, even only using like 3 plus 3 attack, I still did like 100 damage to Volcar with double sting and fillers. And obviously this so-called titan, so no chance that it was a former Swarmy, I'm guessing, I don't know. Probably. And we all know Swarmy is basically God, so if you're a former Swarmy, you are really good. So, you know, that's why I use Beezer and not Swarmy, because Swarmy would have just one-shot the Volcar with Ultra Mega Swarmyuk. So yeah, this is what I did. And also, this is my first challenge yet, with a total of 3 hours and 48 minutes, about 20 minutes faster than the Volcar one. For next week's challenge, I will do a Lampire only run by Iron Hunter's suggestion. Swarm Divergent, Cute Pot, and Scratch are probably gonna be the setup I'll use, plus maybe Energy Drain. But yes, that was it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to thumbs up, like, and subscribe. Thumbs up again, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!